Hi, and welcome back. Continues the series, Hollywood Movie Title. Today, we realize the Inception V2 flying logo animation. For the realization of this animation, we must have cut all the letters, see the image. We open Cinema 4D and import into the front view our reference image. Go to Edit Configuration. In the back panel, we load our JPG image reference. In X size, insert the value 1920. In the MoGraph menu, insert the ModeX tool. Select from the font menu Inception, inline. If we write the lowercase letter, is ready for animation because it is cut as the original movie. But, if you want to use letter without the cuts, just use a uppercase letter. Back to our project, and change the value height, from 200 to 168. And we position the letter, like on our reference image. Change the value of depth, from 20, to 50. Apply fillet cup with step to 1, and radius to 0.25. Finally, fillet type, on linear. We apply the first material and rename building face. We activate only color and apply a white color. We load up our image Inception 02 on texture and apply to our letter. Modify the length U from 100 to 15 and the length V to less 100. We make a render to see the result. Apply filter and modify the gamma from 1 to 0.5. In this way we get a night texture impact. Add a new material and rename dark wall. Activate specular color and bump. Go to color panel and insert the following values, 64, 69, 74. We load texture concrete 040. Apply filter. And modify lightness and brightness to less 15. We set mix mode on add. We go in the bump panel and load the texture. Concrete 035. Edit strength, from 20 to 25. And apply layer filter with brightness contrast and gamma effect. Modify only contrast value, to 33. Go to specular panel, apply the following values, 16, and 24. In the specular color panel, load concrete 035 image. Modify brightness from 100 to 55. To complete in the color panel, lower the mix strength value from 100 to 37. This is our concrete texture. We apply this material to Modex'd I letter, and in the selection line, write C1. So, we put the texture on front of the extrude letter. Repeat this step and we put C2. We repeat this step 2 more times, and insert R1 and R2. So, the texture is on the all bevels. This step will be useful during the rendering animation. We return to the front view. Duplicate the I letter, we position, and write and lowercase. Repeat this step for compose all the letters of the Inception logo. The second I letter of the logo has a different cut, you'll find in the at sign symbol. Finally, the second N letter. You will find in the upper than letter. Back in the perspective view, and make a render to see the result. To eliminate clones materials, we can overlap them on each other. Select all polygons with the concrete material and modify U and Y offset from 0 to 70, U and Y length from 100 to 20. We make a render and view the result. Okay. Now, we proceed with the settings of the scene parameters. Go to Render Settings panel and enter values for 1920x800 from 0 to 100 frame. QuickTime Movie. Anti-aliasing on best. And activate alpha channel. We select all the letters, except P, grouped into a null object, and turn off the visibility. From the MoGraph menu, insert Fracture Object Tool. Drag the Modex'd inside Fracture. To achieve the effect, go to MoGraph menu, and apply, Random Effectors. As we can see, the random effect is automatically assigned in the effector panel, but you can manually drag it inside. We click on the random tool, and in parameter panel, change the coordinate values to 0. Activate scale, an absolute scale. To see the random effect result, we must make modext, a null object, with the command Alt plus G. Modify in the falloff panel, the shape, to cylinder. Activate invert, and insert. 4500, 1000, 2100, 100, less 1430. Fall off value, to 100. The shape, is used to create the animation in a fall off arc. Go to fracture, and in the object panel, we set the explode segments and connect. Back to random parameter, and changing the z-coordinates. Wow! We can see the result, of the random effector. To increase the segments, we have to put on modext, intermediate point on uniform. As we can see, adjusting the z-coordinates, you can modify the distance of the segments, but to get the effect of inception, we have to adjust the origin point of the animation. Go to Effector panel, open the menu min/max, and change the maximum to 0. Okay, this is our result. In the z-coordinate, insert the value 5400, will be animate the strength effector value, after entering a camera. We insert a new camera. Change all values to 0. Except Z to less 1920. Activate the camera, and we can already see results. Now let's go to frame 15, and insert a keyframe on strength with value to 100. Go to frame 60, and insert 0. Rename, fracture P. Repeat the same procedure on all the other letters. Okay, we included the fracture and random effect on all the letters. We see the result. Now, we have to animate the camera for follow the movement of the letters. Select the camera. Go to frame 0. We set the Z value to 0 and insert the first keyframe. Go to frame 97. Insert the Z position with value, less 2300, and activate the keyframe. Okay, we see the movement of the camera. Very, very nice. To improve the movement of the camera, we open with the right button, the F-Curves panel. Follow the changes of the curve in the video image. Okay, so the camera will move in a way that shows all the details of the animation of the logo. To make stronger fall-off cylinder on our random, we have to change its Z coordinate from 0 to 1250. So as we can see, the letters arrive before to middle, and then to sides. If the result of random effect are don't like, you can always duplicate the main one, work on it until you get the result you like. For example, I don't like how it moves the P letter in the first part of the animation, so I decided to change it. The changes are only fall off. You can animate some parameters, such as size offset. The possibilities are endless. Okay. We proceed with the inclusion of a light type area. Activate shadows maps and ambient illumination. In the details panel, modify outer radius from 100 to 745 and size Y to 85. In coordinates panel, Y 435, Z, less 710. We make a render to see the result. Renamed light to area. Insert a new light type spot. With a gray color to 208. Intensity to 90. In active shadows maps. In the details panel, change outer angle to 33 and aspect ratio 3. In coordinates panel, insert the following values: x, 5, y, 1995, z, less 1040. P rotation, less 85 and B rotation, 90. View the result. To make the scene brighter, activate ambient illumination. Rename this light, spot. Turn off the visibility of all the element that make up our scene, except the first N letter. And zoom in on it. Now, we will choose some parts of our letter, from apply the material building face, and to map the rest of the dark wall material. To do this, we must first convert our N-modex layer in a polygonal object. Pressing the C letter with the active layer, and then inside it by pressing the C on the extrude layer. In this way, the conversion maintains the position of all textures included, and we can proceed. I'll explain how. With the active layer, we activate polygon mode selection, active the selection square tool, and disable only select visible elements. Trace a full selection of our letter, choose the parts that will remain with the material building's face. We use the circle move tool, and by pressing the control key, turn off all the polygons of a segment of the letter, in this case, the bottom right of the letter. You can use this tool as a paintbrush. You can work on many parts of the letters, or on a few, to suit your preferences. Make sure all selections are okay, temporarily disable the fracture end layer, and drag by pressing the control key, the dark wall material on the area still active. A menu will open, go to the end polygon. Reactivated fracture end layer. And how we can see from the rendering. We map the letter quickly. Very cool. This is very interesting. With this technique, you can decide which parts of a letter should be treated with infinite possibilities. You can also insert other types of textured buildings. But, before doing this working method, I suggest you put in order the sequence of the letter. It will be easier to identify errors to be corrected. Okay, I repeated the last steps on all the letters in Inception logo, I show you my mapping job. The I letter is mapped all concrete material. C letter has 4 blocks. The E letter has 8 segments. P letter has more maps, has about 15. The T has 8 blocks like the E letter. I letter has 6, and the O letter has only 1 segment. And finally, the N letter is all concrete material. Finally, our animation has a very random movement and an even building texture. Wow! With these steps, you will get fabulous results. Proceed with the first export of rendering. Save a copy of our project, Inception V2A. We make the rendering. Now, we have to get the alpha channel of texture building's face. Rename the file in Inception V2 Face Mask. Create a new material with only luminance active, replace to the building's face material dragging on, with the Alt key pressed. We create a new material with everything turned off, it will be full black color by default. Replace the dark wall material, by dragging it over with the Alt key pressed. Perfect, with a few clicks, we can render our mask, we will use an After Effects. Make sure that the final name is correct, in this case, alpha channel check is not needed. Make a second render. To achieve the mask of the front caps of the animated logo, replace the building's face white with the black material. Create a new material, with white luminance. We put only in selection with name C1. This will take a few minutes. Okay. Perfect. First, save the file as Inception V2 Cap C1 Mask. And make sure that the name of the video is correct, and proceed with the third rendering. To complete rendering process, reopen the first file Inception V2A. Change the dark wall material color with the following values, 118, 126, 134. Replace the building's material, dragging over it with the Alt key pressed. Delete the spotlight. In this file, we modify the area light, with the intensity value, from 120 to 130. And in the Details panel, the outer radius value, from 745 to 100. Y size, to 200. In Coordinates panel, Y, 690. Z, less 155. View the result. Before proceeding with the rendering, save this file as Inception V2B. Check the file name to save the final video, and be active, Alpha Channel. Sorry, I forgot, we must clear the ambient light illumination, in area light. Okay, proceed with the final render. We have thus obtained 4 video files, that will be used for the compositing in After Effects. Open After Effects, and import the 4 render video. Drag the video Inception V2A, below to create the basis of the composition. As we can see, the sequence is turned off. In order to improve the result, we apply the curves filter. Perfect, with this setting, We have already improved, but to complete, we apply a filter exposure to 1.2, and gamma to 0.80. Okay, drag the video inception V2 cap C1 mask, and one duplicate video inception V2A, positions it under the later. At this point, to use the mask, apply a track mat on Luma. So, we automatically got a front caps mask of our logo. We apply an exposure effect, with value, less 2.5. In this way, we give the illusion that the session front of the logo is not light. This layer, should be treated, with an opacity animation, in order to illuminate the front caps at the end of the animated sequence. Insert the first keyframe at 0 frame, with value to 100, and the at 40 frame, with a value, to 0. Now, drag the video inception V2A, and inception V2 cap C1 mask. Apply the track mat, on Luma. In this case, we have the alpha channel of building's face. To normalize the texture, we decrease the opacity to 60. To complete this first part of the video compositing, add Inception V2B video, which will give more nuance to our animated logo. To do this, we put the layers in add mode, and change the opacity to 20. We make a render preview to see the result. Okay, very good. Very realistic. Drag the video Inception V2B, in the icon Create Composition, and rename Inception V2 Preview. Now, insert Inception V2A, under the newly created composition. We set the add mode in the first video. Let's go to 40 frame, this defines the presence of B video in the first part of the animation. Also, in the A composition, on 40 frame, we apply a keyframe opacity, with value to 100. Go to 60 frame. And insert the value, to 0. Instead, in the video beyond 40 frame, insert a keyframe opacity with value, to 0. In the frame 50, to 100. In this way, we created a crossfade in and out, between these two layers. To improve the light of the video B, we apply two filters, brightness, and exposure. The brightness value, is 10, contrast to 5. Exposure value, to 1.2, and 0.8. We make a render preview to see the result. Okay. Now, we insert the audio file to our project. Import Inception V2 audio in the project panel. And drag it, under everything. In order to complete, go to the 87th frame, and insert a keyframe opacity, to video B, with value, to 100, and at the end of the comp, value, 0. Proceed with the settings for the final rendering. Here is the result of our project. Wow, very nice. Okay guys, I'll see the next episode, for the realization of 300 movie title. By Antonio Seri, cheers.